The art of herbal healing has very deep root in Indian culture and folklore. In rural areas, people depend on local traditional healing systems for their primary health care. According to WHO estimate, about 80% of population in developing countries rely on traditional medicine. Millions of rural people use herbal plants as remedy for various diseases. Few plants or their phytochemical constituents have been proven to have medicinal effects and have been approved by many regulatory agencies. Medicinal plants are nature's gift to human beings to promote a disease-free, healthy life. India has about 8% of the world's biodiversity on 2% of the Earth's surface area, making it one of the 12 mega-diverse countries of the world. Medicinal plants as a group comprise approximately 8,000 species and account for around 50% of the higher flowering plant species of India. Most of the medicines are prepared and consumed locally using available plants. It is estimated that nearly 4,600 ethnic communities are using more than 7,500 species of plants for human and veterinary health care in India. This video documentary shows some of the medicinal plants which are commonly used in Indian traditional system of medicine. Terminalia chabula. Terminalia chabula is called the king of medicines in Tibet and is always listed first in the Ayurvedic treatment because of its extraordinary powers of healing. In Ayurveda, it is considered to destroy all diseases and eliminate all waste from the body. At the same time, it is known to promote tissue growth and health. Modern science has found that Terminalia chabula has a strong effect against the herpes simplex virus HSV, has antibacterial activity, and exhibits strong cardiotonic properties. Terminalia chabula also has antioxidant components, which indicates it can increase the life of tissues. Thus, Terminalia chabula can be seen to be a valuable addition to anyone's herbal collection. With its rejuvenating and cleansing properties, Terminalia chabula is excellent for the digestive system. It is also effective for alleviating constipation in general and is helpful for vata persons because it works in the triple R formula, which is a well-balanced digestive and rejuvenating aid. Water in which the fruits have been steeped overnight is a good cooling wash for eyes, affording relief in conjunctivitis and similar afflictions of the eyes. Phyllanthus emblica or Emblica officinalis, commonly known as Indian gooseberry or amla, is an important herbal use in Yunani and Ayurvedic systems of medicine. The plant is used both as a medicine and as a tonic to build up lost vitality and vigor. Phyllanthus emblica is highly nutritious and could be an important dietary source of vitamin C, amino acids, and minerals. The fruit, especially, has been used in Ayurveda as a potent rasayana and in traditional medicine for the treatment of diarrhea, jaundice, and inflammation. The tree is considered sacred by Hindus, as the god Vishnu is believed to dwell here. In traditional Indian medicine, dried and fresh fruits of the plant are used. All parts of the plant are used in herbal preparations, including the fruit, seed, leaves, root, bark, and flowers. According to Ayurveda, amla balances all three doshas, while amla unusually contains 5 out of the 6 tastes recognized by Ayurveda. In Ayurvedic polyherbal formulations, Indian gooseberry is a common constituent and most notably is a primary ingredient in an ancient herbal rasayana called Chyawanprash. Particularly in South India, the fruit is pickled with salt, oil and spices. Terminalia bellerica is the best single herb for controlling kapha. It is a powerful regenerative herb that nourishes the lungs, throat, voice, eyes, and hair, It expels stones or other kapha type accumulations in the digestive, urinary and respiratory tracts. It purges the bowels while simultaneously toning the tissues of the digestive tract. It provides strength to the tissues of the sense organs. Terminalia bellerica is widely used in treatment of headache, leucorrhea, liver diseases and gastrointestinal complaints. The fruit is one among the tripula formula of Ayurveda, which is commonly prescribed in treating asthma, bronchitis, inflammations, sore throat, eye, nose, heart and bladder disorders. The neem tree, Azadirachta indica, has been known as a wonder tree for centuries in the Indian subcontinent. The first indication that the neem was being used as a medical treatment was about 4,500 years ago. That was the high point of the Indian Harappa culture, one of the great civilizations of the ancient world. In those ancient texts, neem is mentioned in almost 100 entries for treating a wide range of diseases and symptoms. Long revered for its many healing properties, neem came close to providing cradle-to-grave health care program and was a part of every aspect of life in many parts of Indian subcontinent. The medical properties of neem have been known to Indians since time immemorial. The earliest Sanskrit medical writings refer to the benefits of neem's fruit, seeds, oil, leaves, roots and bark. Each has been used in the Indian Ayurvedic and Unani systems of medicines and is now being used in the manufacture of modern day medicinals, cosmetics, toiletries and pharmaceuticals. Neem fruits, seeds, oil, leaves, bark and roots have such uses as general antiseptics, treatment for urinary disorders, diarrhea, fever and bronchitis, skin diseases, septic sores, infected burns, hypertension, diabetes and inflammatory diseases. Sarika indica is one of the most leading plants utilizing from ancient times till to date. It is an evergreen tree and a very popular medicinal plant endemic to India. Sarika indica has been greatly used as traditional medicine for woman-related problems such as dysfunctional uterine bleeding, bleeding hemorrhoids, etc. Its original distribution was in central areas of the Deccan Plateau and the middle section of the Western Ghats. It is an endangered tree and listed as vulnerable in IUCN Red List. The Ashoka tree is considered sacred throughout the Indian subcontinent, especially in India and Sri Lanka. This tree has many folkloric, religious and literary associations in the region. For its handsome appearance and the color and abundance of its flowers, the Ashoka tree is often found in royal palace compounds and gardens as well as close to temples throughout India. Garcinia indica, commonly known as kokum, is a fruit-bearing tree that has culinary, pharmaceutical and industrial uses. Garcinia indica is indigenous to the Western Ghats. Of the 35 species found in India, 17 are endemic. Of these, 7 are endemic to the Western Ghats, 6 in the Andaman and Nicobar Islands and 4 in the northeastern region of India. Garcinia indica is a storehouse of medicinal benefits. Juice of kokum fruit helps in the digestion process and offers a cool and refreshing tonic to the body. Kokum fruit is beneficial against problems relating to constipation. The different parts of the kokum tree, such as the bark, rind, pulp, juice, root, and seeds, have numerous health benefits and are utilized in many Ayurvedic preparations. The seed of kokum contains 23-30% oil and it is used in preparation of medicines, cosmetics and confectionery. Consuming kokum juice is said to be beneficial in lowering bad cholesterol levels in the body.